if you would all please stand and join us in singing our opening song.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. I declare to Almighty God, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that I have risen in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have felt, in my thoughts, in my thoughts, in my most basic thoughts. Therefore, I ask you that you may be with me. All the years to come, in the name of God, in the name of God, in the name of God, in the name of God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to the rest of life. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Son, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. You are the mercy. Let us pray. Grant Almighty God, through the yearly observance of Holy Lent, that we may grow in understanding of the richest coming in Christ, and by worthy conduct, pursue their efforts. For Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Reading from the book of Genesis. God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "See, I am now establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, all the birds and the various tame and wild animals that were with you and came out of the ark. I will establish my covenant with you that never again shall all bodily creatures be destroyed by the waters of the flood. There shall not be another flood to devastate the earth." God added, "This the sign that I am giving for all ages to come, as a covenant between me and you, and every living creature with you. I set my bow in the clouds to serve as a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth, and the bow appears in the clouds, I will recall the covenant I have made between me and you and all living things, so that the waters will never again become a flood to destroy all mortal beings. The word of the Lord. Reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, Christ suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might redeem to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the Spirit. In it he also went to preach to the spirits in prison, who had once been disobedient, while God patiently waited in the days of Noah during the building of the ark, in which the few persons, eight in all, were saved through water. This configured baptism, which saves you now, it is not a removal of dirt from the body, but an appeal to God for a clear conscience. Through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who is gone into heaven, and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers subject to him. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, who is the Almighty, begotten of the Father, begotten of not man, Jesus the Father. From him all things are made, for us to be the Father's foundation, the kingdom of heaven. By the Holy Spirit, the Father of faith, who is crucified on the cross of Christ, who suffered death and was dead, and rose again on the third day, and becomes his disciples. He is ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory as a judge of the living and the dead, as a symbol of my knowledge. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the God of God. The Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son, and the Lord and the Lord. There is hope and freedom coming. Father will present our petitions and prayers.
For the church, may the Lord guide and protect you in proclaiming the kingdom of God to all. We pray to the Lord. For those who serve in state and local governments, may the Holy Spirit inspire them in working to be the most vulnerable, especially during war. We pray to the Lord. For those burdened to the point of despair, may God's grace pour out upon them, strengthen and uphold them. We pray to the Lord. For this faith community, may the Lord's present spirit in word and sacrament open our hearts more fully to the gospel message. We pray to the Lord. For those who have died, that they may know the glory and the splendor of heaven. We pray to the Lord. For all of our special intentions, especially for the intention of this year's
that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Give us, dear wife, this position of Lord we pray to make these offerings, for with them we celebrate the beginning of this venerable and sacred time. So Christ our Lord. O Lord, listen. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, mighty and ancient God, to place our hope by abstaining 14 long days from death and sin, to consecrate it to this fact that the pattern of God, our Lord, and our saints. I'm going to go to the hospital. And you holy, O Lord, the Son of our holiness. Make holy, therefore, your sister's brothers, by sending down your spirit upon them like a people, so that they may be confessed the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and went away into the past, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up to you." In the similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for them for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your thanks stretched out to Lord and bring us to the fullness of salvation, together with thanks and sorry hope and comments from our bishop and our departure. Remember also our brothers and sisters of the fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all of our God in the rest. Welcome down to the life of your saints. Have mercy on us, O people, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, our Lord, with the blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints of Jesus, that we have been married to the Pope as such and life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. With him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the name of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. As the Savior stands and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every gracious thing that is peace in our days, and by the help of the mercy, we may be always free from sin and free from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who set the apostles' peace, our leading light and finding, we pray in our sins, but in the face of your trust, and the gracious thing brought by peace and unity in the place of your will, it is in us forever and ever. The peace of the Lord he rejoiced. That's also the shadow of the sun. Hold on, my God, and hold him to face the way that he's alone. Blessed are those called to the supper of him. Where they not know Jesus in the language, I'm going to go to the hospital.
We have a singular announcement this evening. The men's group program starts this next Friday, February 25th. See the bulletin for more details.
And you now work with heavenly bread, by which faith is nourished, hope increased, and its sanity strengthened. We pray, O Lord, that you may learn the hunger for Christ, the true and living bread, and strive to live by every word which is received from your mouth. Through Christ our Lord.
Bow down for the blessing.
In bountiful blessing, O Lord, we say, come down upon your people, that hope may grow in tribulation, hope will be strengthened in temptation, and may eternal redemption be assured. Through Christ our Lord.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Lord, please glorify and glory God in our lives, and receive the God. I'm sorry.